This is a pretty important video for me. I didn't reach 1,000 subscribers. We reached 1,000 subscribers. I don't even know what to say, honestly. It's each time I'm looking at my channel and I see the sub count and it says 1K subscribers, it looks like I fucking inspect elemented it. Like, it's still unbelievable that I was able to do that. It's still unbelievable that that number is actually real and that 1,000 people have actually subscribed. It's I'm sorry, I'm just speechless. I seriously don't know what to say other than thank you. I seriously don't know how to thank you guys enough. The first ever goal that I ever set for myself was 100 subscribers, and I thought I'd never hit 100 subscribers, and I hit 200 and 300 all the way up to 1,000 right now. I just seriously thank you guys. I wonder how many times I'm gonna say thank you in this video. But seriously, like, thank you. I was thinking of a video for a couple days, and I was able to come up with a reaction video, so that's what we're gonna do. Okay, enough of the sad shit. Let's actually just fucking do it. All right, so this is one of my very first videos that I ever made on the channel, and it's a null core video. You see me repping null core all the way since 2017. You feel me? Yeah, this is just a very shitty video. Of course, it's my first video, so it's gonna be shitty. Let's die from cringe. Okay, 2 fucking seconds in the video, and I already hate this shit. I'm going to skip this because I'm not going to give you guys a seizure for fucking watching this, but it's shaky text. Like, why did I do this? Why? Oh, and then it's still flashing. Oh, the pin crop. Oh. I'm so. Why the fuck did I do this? And the rotation transition. Oh my. And then I shoot out a fucking spy from a mile away and keep that in the video. Why did I do that? I don't know. The zoom in. The dude again. And then the white flash whenever I kill someone. I used to think the white flashes whenever I kill someone was like the coolest shit ever. And the slow down and then the cut in the music so it can be super short and I don't have to work as much. And then the shaky text again. Why did I do this? I don't know. I fucking hate myself. Oh god, and then this. So Jay Tanzanite was like a 2017 cheating YouTuber, and he was my main inspiration for cheating content. I think Twilight was also there a bit, but it was mainly Jay Tanzanite's video about insta decloaking, where back then, some people might know this, but there is something called sequence freezing, and you'd be able to basically do a fuck ton of awesome things. Imagine being set on fire and then pressing a key and instantly like getting rid of the afterburn as any class at any time you want. And imagine taunt canceling. So say you were in a taunt and you can just press the key and you can get out of it. And you can also do that with cloaking. Like, you know, whenever you uncloak, it takes a second. You were able to instantly decloak and just fucking stab someone with auto backstab. And I saw this video on it, and that was the coolest shit ever to me. And Jay Tanzanite has always been like my biggest inspiration. And I think he actually commented. Yeah, he commented on this video. And then he did in the replies. And then it's just me fanboying over him because he was like such a big inspiration to me. What's this? Oh god. More bullshit text. Why did I fucking. Oh, the effects. And I put Sonic fan in my name just to piss people off because people fucking like when they heard that I was a Sonic fan, they would fucking like go ape shit and they would be like, "You Sonic fag." Like, it was so funny. So I put it in my name just to piss people off. Oh, like why? And it's like all in Sony Vegas too. Oh, the old null core, god. Oh, and then fucking metal. Oh my god. I don't know if you remember this metal. I don't know if you're watching. And then whenever, if you got kicked, you can rejoin, but whenever that wasn't patched, Orgasm. Oh, the shitty fucking, the motion tracking. The hell, why am I anti-aiming? Oh, the transition, why? And then I linked fucking metal. Oh, and the 1 FPS slowdown. God, I'm so sorry. If any of you guys watched these before, I am so sorry what I did to you. All right, now this is with Lithium back in 2018. For those who don't know, this is also that thing that I was talking about called sequence freezing. Imagine if you were able to shoot every single sticky, all 8 stickies, out at once. That's what you could do with sequence freezing. That's fucking insane. And Lithium had that. And when that was a thing, I fucking loved it. Just watch this. It's so fucking good. This video I actually don't mind too much. I don't know why I used demos. I thought it was smooth back then. But yeah, look at that shit. Like, imagine if that was in TF2 still. That would fucking own. I said one in 2018. And then the text. Why? Okay. What I did in this video, I think this is around the time whenever I first figured out that backtrack spy, like fake latency and backtrack and auto backstab was funny as fuck. And everybody fucking used this song back then, by the way. And yeah, see, I even fucking seen it in the video. The editing is cool, though. Why didn't I just cut here? Oh, I'm sorry if you didn't catch it, by the way. I said now that's a one. Oh my god, dude. Oh, that was ironic, but still. Just seeing that I did that. I remember this is like the coolest shit to me back then. Below gay, I was doing that in 2018. Then yeah, after I got balanced, I fucking backstabbed everyone, and I think we won. No. And yeah, I think I was messaging someone. Yeah, I was messaging C1R in 2018. Damn. This game is gay. Yeah? Yeah, 2018 talent. Is that just the text? Just this game is gay. Wait, no, I added something after this. I know. I remember this. It's gonna be like a. Yeah, it said read of gay. Fucking. Okay. I actually forgot to go through these videos. And I'm not going to go through these videos for a very specific reason, mainly because of my voice. I'm sorry, I cannot listen to this. But for those who don't know, there's this guy named Islander who used to do YouTube. He unfortunately stopped. I just fucked around, basically, and I think he commented on this too, didn't he? Yeah, he said, LMAO, I love this, and then so did his friend right here. So, yeah, I'm gonna watch like 5 seconds of this video and then not because. Just here, I think it's in the first 5 seconds. This video starts. Oh, you hear my fucking voice? Look, listen.
I want to make it clear.
What the fuck? Nah, I'm not even listening to. Oh god, and in this video, I remember on Nullcore, my computer used to be so bad. I don't think it was the bad computer. I think I just had to factory reset it because I had so much shit. But I had to disable the lighting just to get somewhat decent FPS. And even still, you can see on the top right of that, it's red and it says like 40 something FPS.
The
the beginning of this video is just gonna be.
I remember this too. Wow. Burning with him, you faggot. Well, why do you say it like that? Burning with him, you faggot. Burning with him, you faggot.
You're partying with him, you faggot.
Remember whenever Elder God Heavy used to not use a voice changer? Elder God Heavy as a medic? This is a rare fucking sight. When was the last time you saw Elder God Heavy play something else other than Heavy? Elder God Heavy laughing at me while playing medic. Like, what? What is that? What even is that?
Shut up!
But this voice chat sometimes.
And then I tell him to shut the fuck up and then he just actually shuts up. Alright, I'm done watching my old videos. I keep losing brain cells whenever I watch my old videos. But here's a message from my good friend. He has been my channel designer for so long and he's been doing it for absolutely free. For free. And I really appreciate him. I'll let him advertise for a little bit and then it'll go to the outro.
Hi, I'm Timothy. Or you can call me Timmy, Tim, whatever you want, honestly. I'm a small YouTuber who tries to upload weekly cheating content like Umbuku. As you've maybe seen, I'm also the channel designer for Umbuku. Back then when I used to be legit, I used to be very intrigued by the SFM community and how it worked. Everyone started somewhere, and I was shit for the first year like everybody else. Had to get used to the lighting, how posing works and stuff using the... Then I started watching YouTube videos like Stag or Doomsday.exe to improve my artwork in SFM. And 4 years ago, I found out that Photoshop existed. So I started using my small experience of drawing in Photoshop with SFM with only a mouse. Because I was too poor to afford a drawing tablet and I still am. Many, many SFMs later on, I have a pretty standard idea on how lighting, effects and perspective works. It took me a long while to get here, but honestly, like, if you enjoy something that much, you should just honestly continue doing it, if it's how you spend your time. Everyone has their own little thing, and SFM and Photoshop is my little thing. I must say though, I really went all out on this picture. Something sparked in between me to make it look good. I even told Tadon, like, goddammit, like, I wanna get this, like, really good, like, good. So, I started listening to music, which is a great inspirator for me, just trying to feel the artist's emotion and his message he wants to deliver to the world while making his music. Mix that with some creativity and a spark of motivation, and voila, I made this little thing right here. So, to be quite honest, I'm pretty happy with it myself. I tried a lot of different things I wouldn't usually do on my SFMs. For example, I tried doing shoelaces, and making the boots look like sneakers, or making these weird flame effects around the scout, or generally just trying to overpaint something. It's usually not a lot of people who do that in SFM with Photoshop, so it's quite something new for me, and I did that like 4 years ago already. I was pretty bad at it because I didn't know how colors work and so on, but now I'm pretty good with it, I must say so myself. Not into the level like a real artist is, but like I would say I'm pretty good at it. Not the best out there, but I'm definitely up there, I must say. Also, if you want something like this, but which you can see on Umbuku's channel, just check out my YouTube channel or join Umbuku's Discord channel so you can contact me and ask me for prices, so on and so forth. But yeah, that's everything I wanted to say. I will give it back to Talon now.
That's the video. Those very shitty videos back then from 2017. And to still shitty videos. I'm in absolute fucking disbelief that we hit 1,000 subs. Just seriously, thank you. Thank you guys so much. To all the people that want to see me die because I cheat in a video game. To all the people that just click on a video just to dislike it. Or to tell me to die in the comments. Or to shit talk me in the comments. And to the people that actually do enjoy the content. The ones who do just view the video, like it. And the people who are subscribed and leave nice comments, every single one of you I appreciate and I love. Because both of those type of people help me grow. And I seriously, I don't know what I'd do without you guys. Like, I fucking love you guys, seriously. Like, I know I've said thank you 1,000 times, but I hope you can understand this current situation. I love you guys. Thank you again. Peace out.